ABC 15 Sonoran Living Live. Adventure. Your health. Your life. This is Sonoran Living Live.
Well, the struggling economy and high gas prices, they're sending ripples through all industries, especially travel, or at least that's what we hear. But this morning, we are tackling some travel questions with travel expert Chris McGinnis. He joins us live this morning from the shores of Lake Tahoe. Such a beautiful place. I was there a couple weeks ago. You're such a lucky dog.
It's a nice place to be, I have to tell you.
Oh, it looks beautiful out there. Well, that would be a nice place to visit. You know, they're talking about summer travel, how people just aren't going anywhere because it's so expensive. True or false?
Yeah, well, I really have to say that's false. You know, the staycation has been the buzzword we've been hearing all summer long about people staying home this summer. But when you look at the numbers coming out from the airlines, for example, it's just not true. In July, the airlines reported that their load factors were only down about 2 or 3%. That's not a big drop-off. At Expedia, our bookings are actually up 10% year over year. So, you know, I know that there are, economic news is a little murky right now, but it's just not enough to keep Americans home this summer. The summer vacation is part of our heritage. It's what we do. And people are still out there. It's going to be crowded this weekend. It's been crowded almost all summer long.
Okay, so people need to get away for the summer, so they're obviously making plans and they're really trying to do it. But let's talk about Thanksgiving and, you know, Christmas, the holidays.
Sure.
I have a wedding coming up Thanksgiving and I'm freaking out.
Okay, well, you know, this is the first time in many years, or I think maybe ever, that we've been looking at holiday airfares this far out. Typically, you think about holidays right around Halloween. But now, with what's going on with the airlines, people really are starting to be very concerned about it. But we did some spot checking recently and found that airfares around Thanksgiving and Christmas are not that much different than they were last year between the most popular major routes in the country. So I advise people to go ahead and take a look right now and see what the airfares are. And if you see a reasonable fare and you can make that commitment, go ahead and make that reservation right now. The fares are not going to come down any between now and then. And like I said, if you can make that commitment, go ahead and do it.
Yeah, so don't hold out for those specials that they're going to run in the next month or two because you don't think it's going to happen.
No, no. And if it does, it might be $10 here, $10 there. But for the most part, when the airlines start to remove capacity, park a few planes in the desert, the fares are going to continue to go up.
All right, let's talk about international travel. What if people want to take some, you know, some longer trips and some bigger trips?
Well, you know, interestingly, the dollar's been weakening over the past couple of years, making Europe extremely expensive for Americans. But nonetheless, we are a nation of intrepid travelers, and about 3% more people are going overseas this year than they did last summer. They may not be going to the most expensive destinations like London or Paris or Rome, but instead they're heading to Eastern Europe, to countries like Poland or Croatia. There's also been a big uptick in interest to Latin America, Mexico, and Argentina. As a matter of fact, in Argentina, the tourism office there says that arrivals by Americans are up 30% over the last 2 years.
Well, what are some great places? I mean, we live in the desert. We want to get away. Are there some great places that we should be thinking of where we should go? Maybe some last-minute travel spots?
Yeah, well, you know, one of the best deals for fall travel is cruises. And if you want to jump in your car and head over to Long Beach in California, you can get a 7-night cruise for about $550 a night. That's a great deal when you consider that's less than $550 for a 7-night cruise. That's less than $100 a night. That includes your hotel, which is your berth in the cruise ship, food and entertainment.
And it's not that far, so you can drive there. You don't have to worry about paying airfare to get there.
Or the congestion, the delays, and everything else that's kind of, you know, turned air travel into somewhat of a hassle.
Any other travel trends, things that we should be looking for? People heading off to the sunny spots, the cold spots, Tahoe maybe?
Yeah, well, you know, this is a great destination. And it's not too far from Phoenix, and it's not too expensive to get here to fly up to Reno. You could even drive up here. But what's beautiful about Lake Tahoe is it's a beautiful, as you can tell, summer destination, but it's also a great fall destination. You know, the leaves start to turn here in about a month, and then it turns into ski season. So it's really kind of a year-round destination. Great place to come. I'm happy to be here.
Oh, well, I would be too. Actually, in the fall here, it's going to be really beautiful, so we won't have to go anywhere. Thank you very much. All right, well, we're going to have more on these travel myths on SonoranLiving.com. We're putting it all to rest. Steph?